For nearly 70 years, I have kept a tradition of speaking to you plainly and from the heart. So I'm grateful to the opportunity to say whatever I like without anyone putting words in my mouth. 2020 has been a challenging year for us all. A year when most of you, thanks to toilet roll shortages, have finally understood how it feels to have a predicament on the throne. One thing that has sustained many of us is our families, which is why I was so saddened by the departure of Harry and Meghan. There are few things more hurtful than someone telling you they prefer the company of Canadians.
Who's that sexy thing I see over there? That's me, standing in the mirror. What's that icy thing hanging around my neck? That's gold, show me some respect. Oh.
But at least I still have my beloved Andrew close by. It seems unlikely he'll be heading to North America anytime soon. I'm under strict orders from Philip not to, but as he's nodded off in front of Home Alone 2...
A special someone, it seems, is what one might call queen for the day. Oh, really? I'm the queen every day, but all right. No need to be cheeky. Let's begin.
Happy birthday, Lisa. While it's true that you don't live in Buckingham Palace and aren't seen about town sporting spectacular headwear or acknowledging crowds with a royal side-to-side wrist wave, I... Oh, no. Total rubbish, must start over. Abso-bloody-lutely. Wishing you a most joyous birthday, Lisa. It is my sincerest pleasure to proclaim you queen for the day. You are truly magnificent. Have a smashing good birthday. Cheers, Toodle-pip.
In fact, there's something I'm rather excited to share with you all.